Hello friends, welcome to my second video. I'm very much thankful for liking and subscribing my channel. I hope I will be sharing my knowledge and many references or anything as it was in the earlier, and it will be much better. I will assure you that. Okay, you will be gaining a lot. Now let us move to our second part, which is quality control tools and inspection. Okay, let us see this. Welcome friends. Last time we ended our session with the quality control, and we'll continue from the same pace, same topic, but the next step of quality control is the tools to control the quality. Now you can see, you can like many of my viewers will be young engineers, or many will be experienced engineers. So let me confirm that always there are tools to measure the quality control. We are not inspectors, we are quality control engineers. So when you say we have to control the quality, you cannot control the quality without some tools. Now what are those tools? You can see on your screen that there are 10 tools we have mentioned. Out of that, first one is cause and effect diagram, check sheet, control chart, data collection, flow chart, histogram, Pareto analysis, pie chart, run chart, and scattered diagram. Many of my fellow engineers or the viewers will be already aware of some of the things, and commonly used tools are data collection. I will be marking here the data collection, control charts, check sheet, and cause and effect diagram. But all of these will be or can be put on the work only when we know the flow chart. Flow chart is a very vital tool. That it's like, for me, it's like a proactive tool. If you or anyone who develops a flow chart is nothing but a sequence of activities or sequence of reporting, sequence of workflow, or whatever it is, it's a sequence. People will understand, okay, if one sequence is done, one activity is done, what is the next? What is the next? What is the next? What is next? If this fails, what to do? If this passes, where it goes? People will be aware of the process. And my friends, if you are aware of the process, it's very easy to put your checkpoints at specific critical activities. You can identify the present critical activities at every stage, or whenever you want. Which stage you want to have a more control or more checkpoint, you can put there the checkpoint. To understand that, flow chart is very important, my friends. Next comes is the data collection. For me, it's my view. The data collection is nothing but, it's as we all learnt in engineering and our colleges, that survey concept. Get the more and more possible data to calculate the next level, right? Whole to the point, right? Like this. So you have, the more data you collect, more confidence level, more the accuracy will be there with you about the available data to assess or to resolve or solve or to judge or to report or to record, whatever it may be. The more data we have, more accurate information we have, it will be more easy to solve it, right? So data collection is more important. How do we collect the data? There are many ways. One is through check sheets, right? The check sheets. Check sheets is nothing but our inspection request. Many of you will be calling as a request for inspections. Okay, then pre-concrete, post-concrete checklist, cube form, cube reports, or your third-party test reports. It may be many kind of check sheets you will be having. Plaster checklist, blockwork checklist, your fill density, maximum MDD, MDD reports, or moisture content reports, or gradation reports. Many reports are there in the construction industry or in the construction activities. So you collect all those things, you gather it in a file Okay, that is nothing but your check sheets. And a group of check sheets or group of reports or whatever it is, it will be a data collection for a QC engineer. It may be a record for document control, it may be a record for billing person, but for us, it's a data. The data, more the data, more the confidence. Always be aware of it. Okay, then histogram, again it will be done on the basis of your data collection. Pareto analysis will be on the data connection. All these things, if you don't have data, sorry boss, it's very difficult to analyze and control the quality. Now, after all this, the main thing comes in the picture is inspection. Inspection is the key here. Now, my friends, what do you mean by inspection? Right? Let us move to the next slide to understand what do we understand about inspection. Okay? Yes, welcome again. Inspection, you can see the inspection is nothing but a witness. Whatever we witness, we inspect. Many QC engineers have a very wrong concept that we are all police. Okay, we are here to fault find. We are here to catch some thief. Please be aware that, friends, we are not police. We are not here to fault find. If you think like that, please change your mindset to a productivity that we are not here to do police job, right? Because there are many reasons. I will explain you why we say that we are not police, that we are equally qualified as a construction engineer, we are equally qualified as a designer, we are equally qualified as our quantity surveyors, right? When we are equally qualified, they are doing their job, we have to do our job. We never say that we are here to fault find or catch the mistakes like thieves, right? Please try to understand this. Okay, now let us go to the next process. What is this? Inspection is nothing but is the process of measuring quality of the material activity in terms of established approved specification and standard. It never says that keep an eye on execution engineer or a construction engineer, keep an eye on contractors works, keep an eye on no, it's not that. It's just measuring the quality of, I'm talking about quality inspection or quality inspectors or quality engineers in terms of only quality. So it's measuring the quality of materials activity in terms of established or approved specification or standards, right? Nothing personal. Now, what does this inspection department performs? Major role by inspection department is material, incoming material, work in process inspections, inspection of right tools of the specific purpose, periodical inspection of measuring equipment and gauges, inspection of finished products, reworking of defective items, or we can call it as salvaging, complaint attending, and metallurgical testing, witnesses or inspection. We'll go the next step, human errors in the later. Let us discuss on this part first. What do we call it as incoming raw material? You tell me, sir, why we need incoming raw material inspection? As if you recollect my old video, I have clearly mentioned that raw material or incoming material plays 70% of the seriousness of the work in the project. Now, if your raw material is incoming raw material, or any, it may be anything, raw material is raw material. It may be a concrete, it may be your water tap, it may be a pipe, it may be a hume pipe, it may be anything. It may be cement, it may be sand, it may be aggregate, it may be anything. When it is a raw material, if raw material quality is not good, friends, you cannot achieve a good quality output. So first role is inspecting the incoming of raw material. Second comes is, once that raw material comes, it the in place, how it is in place, whether the raw material is used in a right way. Okay, because material is good, but workmanship affects, then there is no use of that. So work in process inspection, whether the raw materials, whether the manpower is good, because many times we have a good raw material, good quality material, but we have only agricultural farmers working as a mason, working as a barbenders, working as a excavating people. It's very difficult them to assess or educate it. So inspecting those elements of the working is very much important. Next comes is right tools for right specific purpose. Right tools is a very key element of the project. See, yesterday I was going through one of my site, before lockdown, I was moving through my site and we saw people are still in the era of using 6 inches right angle for measuring 9 inches wall or a corner of the internal corner or out external corner of the wall. My friends, with 6 inch right angles, how can you accurately measure the right angle? Always it should be a 1 feet or a 2 feet right angle for a better or accurate results. Many people may differ with my opinion, but my guys, my friends, I am sharing you with my experience. Okay, so we should always insist it is, see, we have to create a change in the industry. Management or construction people always have their own pressure of completion the work, completing the budget and all. It is us who are representing the company. Ultimately, at the end of the project, it is us or a quality department who has to face many, many consequences. So insist on the right tools on the right time or a specific purpose. You cannot use a putty blade for plaster, right? It may be a small touch up, but still they have to have a proper tool for plaster and proper tool for putty works. You cannot use putty works tools for plaster or plaster work, plaster tools for block works. It's just example. Okay, next, periodical inspection of measuring equipment. Guys, again I'll insist on measuring equipments. Measuring equipments are the final products, final equipments are the key equipments which will give you the data. The data, for example, you have a measuring tape. If your measuring tape, there are n number of companies who are manufacturing the measuring tape, and if your measuring tape doesn't have calibration report, then you will be ending up in errors, maybe by 1 mm or 5 mm or 6 mm, but 1 mm per 1 millimeter, 1 mm per 1 meter will equal to 10 mm per 10 meters. Please do focus on using inspection of measuring equipments and gauges. This is a vital thing because this will give you the data for quality control. I'm repeating, these measuring equipments will give you the data. It may be a dial gauge, it may be a flask, it may be a measuring cylinder, it may be anything, it may be anything which is used for measurement or collecting the data or result. We have to have a periodical inspection of these equipment because these are the judging things, right? Then comes finished product inspection. As we were controlling on raw material, we have controlled on right tools, we have controlled on working process, we have controlled on measuring equipment. 80 to 90% times there will be unhuman errors. Human errors, unhuman errors, right? It may be anything. It may be a vibration, it may be anything due to what the honeycomb has come. So finished product inspection is also important. For example, honeycombs, for example, cavity in the concrete, for example, cracks in the block work, for example, there may be n number of examples I can give here, but finished product inspection is also equally important. When you do the finished product inspection, you will get the data about the defects on the surface or finished product. then you can give the solution, or you can rework on the defective items, right? How you will rework? Based on the complaint attending, based on this. And last one is metallurgical testing witness. It is nothing but our periodical material sampling and testing in the third party. And nowadays, third party, I don't want to point out anyone's ethics or working culture, but it is very difficult to believe their ethics of the work. So it is always suggested that please do witness yourself at the laboratory, which is approved or accredited by NABL. And do please do check the NABL accreditation report, where it will be the NABL will be given to specific tests. And if that particular test is not there in the NABL accredited laboratory, or they may be doing some, many times the laboratories will be carrying out the test, but those tests will not be accredited under NABL. So in that case, they are not supposed to use NABL logo on their reports. So these are all things comes under our metallurgical testing witness and inspections. Okay, and the last column or last topic I can say for today's slides, that is human errors in inspections are mainly due to one, technique errors, inadvertent errors, conscious errors, communication errors. My friends, out of this, technique errors are always, not always, but many times, as in my experience, it is because of using wrong tools for wrong things. Okay, if I use laser tool to measure this, measure the ground levels, it's a technique. I have a latest technology, but laser level is for, it comes with the limitations like 60 meters, 40 meters, 80 meters. So again, the issue of right tools for right work comes in picture. When it comes to conscious error and communication errors, these things, consciousness is very, very, very important. Consciousness is nothing but you are related to brain, but it's related to your presence of mind at the spot or on the spot. What I am doing? Am I checking beam? Am I checking column? Am I checking wall? It's as a standard practice, we always say that wall has to be checked with the plumb on one side always, because other side, because of inconsistent block casting, which always it will not give an accurate result on the other side. I do agree with this, but if you don't have conscious culture on this, many of my friends have complained during me, sir, one side I'm getting the plumb, other side it's not coming. Come on, you cannot achieve plumb on other side of the wall unless until you have a perfect blocks cast at the fabrication or manufacturing yard. This is just an example. So conscious error, many times we force contractor to do which is not logically correct, right? And many times we become a funny part in front of contractor. And second thing is communication. Communication error is 80% responsible for the errors happening at site. Communication means, example, there is a very, very best example, very old example, when I used to hear from my father, the communication errors, like one person has applied for leave to his boss, and he has written that mere papa ajmer gaye hain, and the boss, he has read it that mere papa aaj mar gaye hain. These are all it may be a funny part, but it's a very vital example for communication errors. Be clear what you instruct your contractor. Be clear what is the requirement of the project. Be clear what you write in the email. Be clear what you write in your inspection request or a request for inspection checklist as a comment. We should be very clear. Whatever you checked, double check, triple check. It may be possible that you may take some time and you may borrow some time from contractor or your execution team to understand with the requirement, and then you may write it. But the communication error is a 70% responsible of all the errors. So please try to avoid this communication errors in your projects. Okay, this is a small part. Since I wanted to limit it within the some time duration, I have limited it. Then next time we will go with the quality assurance and standard practices in the industries. Thank you guys. Be safe, be at home, and enjoy.